Hello dear students, welcome to my computer science class. So we were discussing the chapter computer network. In the previous part I have discussed what is a computer network, the size of a network, that size of network can be as small as two computers or it can be as vast as the whole world, and the different network hardware components, and the different components were the computer, the network interface card, the connector, cables and the different resources. Now we have to start with need for a network, why networking is required. So let us start today's lecture. You can share resources such as hardware devices, software programs, data and information with the help of network. Sharing resources saves time and money. So basically, networking is required to share the hardware, the software, data and information, and it is required for communication also. And networking saves our time as well as money. Suppose, how does it save time and money? Suppose if there are 20 computers in a computer lab and each computer requires a printout and there is no networking, what will happen? We will require a printer each with a computer system so that we can take a printout. So 40 printers or 20 printers, purchasing 20 printers will cost more. So sharing resources saves money and time also. If we have only one printer and we have to take a printout, what will happen first of all, and there is no networking, we have to save the data or information in a pen drive or in a CD, then we have to transfer it to the device or computer in which printer is there. So it will take more time as compared to network devices. So let us see all these features in detail. So first of all, hardware sharing. In a network environment, each computer on a network can access and use hardware available on the network. Suppose there are a number of personal computers on a network and each one needs to use a laser printer. If the personal computers and the laser printers are connected in a network, each personal computer user can access the laser printer over the network whenever he or she needs it. So as I have told that in an institution, what happens? What will happen? If there, generally in an institution, there are number of computers and generally all the systems are used by different users and they require printing or printouts time to time. So if there is a networking, they can easily take printouts using a single printer. Otherwise, either each system will require a separate printer, which means a lot of investment, a lot of maintenance, a lot of space, because one printer will require less space, less maintenance as compared to 20 printers, because then that particular institution or particular room requires space for 20 more printers and maintenance of these printers also. So hardware sharing removes all these hassles, extra cost, extra maintenance and extra space. Now second is data and information sharing. In a network environment, any authorized user can use a computer to access data and information stored on other computers in the network. A large company, for example, might store a database of customer information on a server's hard disk. any authorized person, including a mobile user using a handheld computer, can connect to the network and can access the database. The capability of providing access to and storage of data and information on shared storage devices is an important feature of many networks. So secondly, data and information sharing. Suppose how information is shared. If networking is done, so what happens? The data and information is shared among all the systems. So suppose in a large company or in a large firm, a database of its customers are there. So they can access the database anywhere. Like suppose you have purchased a branded product from a city different to the city you are presently residing in. Like you are presently in Kolkata or presently in Delhi and you have purchased a product from Mumbai. But there are number of online stores of that particular company. So what will happen? And if you have an issue, you can call from anywhere that I have purchased a product of this company from your store in Mumbai and presently I'm in Delhi. Can you help me? And generally these companies, they have their database. They will check that whether you have purchased the product and they will provide you with technical support for that product. That means networking has benefited the user as well as the person from the firm, because the information is being shared. Like you want to share your pictures with your relatives sitting in some different country or some different continent, you can share it easily. It is possible only because of networking. Now next is software sharing. So this was data and information sharing, like you are sharing your data or a company is sharing its data with other persons or employees of the same firm. Now software sharing. Network lets people gain access to programs such as a spreadsheet or word processor stored on a central computer. Using their own computers, individuals can gain access to and work with the programs by sharing a program. A company can avoid having to install a copy of program on each person's computer separately. So we can share software programs also using the network. Generally the companies, what they do, they share the software program in a single system and then the employees or the users can use the program if they are on the network. So this avoids the hassles of installing the same program in each computer system and thus save the space memory of the system, that if the system has 500 GBs of memory and that particular program requires 2 to 3 GBs of memory, so we have saved 2 to 3 GBs of memory in each system. So these were the reasons for the need of networking. First is hardware sharing. We can share hardware. Second, we can share data and information, and it helps to ease the records. It helps the users to use the information anywhere or anytime. Now, next is software sharing. We can share the software programs also using the networking. Now, types of network. There are three types of networks. First is local area network, which in short is called as LAN, metropolitan area network or MAN, and wide area network or WAN. So let us first discuss what is LAN or local area network. A local area network is a network that connects the computers and the devices in a limited geographical area, such as home, school computer laboratory, office building, or closely positioned group of buildings. Each computer or device on the network is a node. Often the nodes are connected to the LAN wire cables. So what is local area network? When computers are networked in a small area, like in at home, if you have 2 to 3 computers and they are connected, they will be called as a local area network. Or in your school computer lab, the computers are connected, so it will be called as a local area network. In an office building also, it will be called as a LAN. And each computer, suppose this is a LAN connection, 3 computers at your home, they are connected with each other, then it will be a LAN. And each system, these all will be called as a node. And they are connected via cables. These connections are through, they are interconnected with the use of cables. Now, second type of networking is MAN or Metropolitan Area Network. MAN is a network that connects the local area networks in a metropolitan area, such as a city or town. A MAN typically includes one or more LANs but covers a small geographic area than WAN. Telephone companies, cable television operators, and other organizations use MAN network. So what is MAN? If the networking is in an area larger than a building or institution, but like in a city, then it will be called as a MAN. But it is smaller than a WAN. WAN is wide area network. We will study what is WAN. So when LAN, when networking is done in a metropolitan area like a city or town, then it is called as MAN. For example, the examples are the different telephone companies, your cable television operators, they all use MAN or metropolitan area network. So this is a city and the computers are interconnected with each other, then it will be called as MAN. Now the next third type of network is WAN or wide area network. The wide area network is the vastest of all types of networks. The network may cover a whole country or the world. It can be one large network or can consist of multiple LANs connected together. Internet, an example of WAN. So when the computers all around the world, they are connected together, they are called as, it is called as WAN or wide area network. And the example is internet. So these are the three different types of networking. First is LAN, which covers a building or an institution. Second is MAN, in which networking is done in a metropolitan area like a city or town. And third is WAN or wide area network. It is the vastest of all the networks and it covers almost a whole country or it can cover the whole world. And the example is internet. So this was all about the different types of networks. So revise the chapter well, students. I hope you have understood this part of the video properly. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Till then, students, revise the chapter well, read the chapter, Thank you, students.